Today on HackTip, we're using the find command, and this HackTip is brought to you by Eero. Welcome to HackTip, the show where we break down concepts, tools, and techniques for hackers, gurus, and IT ninjas. I'm your host, Shannon Morse, and today we are talking about the find command. So one of my viewers reached out on Twitter and asked, have you done an episode on the find command? And I was like, I am now, so here is your find command episode, sir. It's sort of like locate and grep, but find just happens to be, well, pretty powerful. I mentioned it in a previous episode, but it does make sense to repeat it here. Locate depends on an ever-changing database, so it is fast, but it is dependent. Find searches on the fly, and you can specify search criteria. It is slower, but it can do a lot more than locate can, so let's go through some of the options that are most useful, well, at least I consider them most useful, with find. So find searches recursively through directories, starting with the top directory and on down. So you can simply type something like this, find.tacname, and I'm gonna use wallpaper2.png as an example. And this will find my wallpaper PNG file. How exciting. Now if I type something similar, find.tacname wallpaper with no 2.png after it, it won't find anything because I did not include any kind of wildcard after it, so it was expecting to find something specifically called wallpaper. Another thing to keep in mind, find includes folders because folders are also considered files. So, to add a wildcard, you just gotta stick it in quotes, something like this. I would type in find.tacname wallpaper, add an asterisk, and then close out those quotes. Okay, so this will find all of my files that have wallpaper in the name. In this case, using the dot tells find that I want to use a relative path for output. You could also use a forward slash, which tells it to use an absolute path instead. So if I did that, and I'll go ahead and try testing it. Okay, so that found a lot of information, so I think I'll just clear that out and stick with the period instead because it's much easier to understand on camera at least. So we're going to stick with the period. Next up, you can search by ownership. So to do this, you simply type in something like find tac user, and I'm gonna use myself as an example, hit enter. All right, so this will find everything that is owned by that user. Alternatively, if you have another user that you want to search under, or if you want to find anything that is not owned by Snubs, you can add an exclamation point right after the period, and then hit enter. And it's not going to find anything because I own everything on the system, so no surprise there. But this is going to search for files that are owned by anyone that is not Snubs in this case. So this can be super useful if you need to change the ownership of files with chown, for example. And I spoke previously on chown in a previous hack tip. Now you can do the same thing with groups as well. You simply take, instead of putting user, you would change that to a group. So I'll type in group. And for this example, I don't have a lot of groups on this machine. I'll just use SambaShare. And I don't think it'll find anything. Actually, I'll use the exclamation. So that is going to find everything that is not in the SambaShare group because just so happens, I don't have anything in the SambaShare group right now. But if I did want to find something that has a group that I need to change, I can simply go on from there and use chgrp, which is change group, for anything that's in the wrong group. Now I will give you a few more examples to find right after this break. When you're looking to improve your wireless network, making sure that your entire home has a strong signal is a definite must. That's where Eero comes in. They are launching the very first second generation mesh Wi-Fi system that comes with one Eero and 1 to 2 beacons. These are mesh access points, they're not extenders, they're much smaller than the originals, they plug into an outlet, they have an ambient night light in case you gotta get up in the middle of the night, and they are more powerful than the originals as well. But if you already have the original Eero devices, that's totally cool too. Eero has your back. These babies are backwards compatible and they can be purchased separately. So systems start at $399 for all of the components together, but if you just want to buy one beacon to add on, you totally can, and those are $149 each. We've gotten a chance to test these in the warehouse, so I can honestly say our wireless usually does not reach from one end to another, but the Eero Mesh does a really great job of fixing that headache and giving me the speeds that I pay for from my ISP. Plus, it's very easy to set up, it's really reliable too. Eero is also announcing the Eero Plus subscription, which includes advanced network security monitoring, supplementing the features that are already built in that you get for free with the device, and content filtering, which is also really great for houses with kids. Now, with any system, you get automatic updates, you get two-factor authentication for your admin access, you get Eero's backing with a bug bounty program, and they also do third-party audits, which is awesome. We also have a coupon code for you for free overnight shipping to the US or Canada. You can visit Eero.com and at checkout, select overnight shipping, enter hack tip, H-A-K tip, to make it free. Check it out and learn more at Eero.com. We are now back with Find. So next up is searching by file size. This can be super useful if you're looking for a larger file on your computer, maybe to save some room, you want to find some files to delete, or you want to find a specific video that you had downloaded or something like that. So to do this, you simply type in find period tack size. So I'm changing that to size this time, and I'm going to use an example that's very specific. It's 854K in my case. So that doesn't show anything. Why? That is because it's looking for a file that is exactly that file size, and I don't have anything that is exactly that file size. If I want to find anything that's larger than 854 kilobytes, I can add the plus right in front of the number, and that will find anything that is larger than that 854 kilobytes. I could also do the same thing if I want to find anything smaller with a minus instead of a plus. And of course, we're going to find a lot of info there, so let's stick to plus instead, because it's a great example. So the K in this case stands for kilobytes. That's probably very obvious. Then we also have a B for 512 byte blocks. That's the default. So if you don't put a letter after your number, it's just going to stick with 512 byte blocks. C is for bytes, B-Y-T-E-S. K is for kilobytes. An uppercase M is for megabytes. And an uppercase G is for gigabytes. I don't think they have anything for terabytes yet. We'll see in the near future. Comment below if they do, but I'm pretty sure they don't. Lastly for today, I also wanted to touch on the type option. So type allows you to look for a specific file type, be it a regular file, a symbolic link, a directory, or whatever it might be. So remember that everything on a Unix system is a file in some way, shape, or form. I covered this really early on in my series of Linux hack tips, so check out our YouTube playlist for those older episodes. So to do this, I can use find again. I'll type in find dot tack type, and I'm going to use D to see all of the directories that are currently available on my computer. If you want to search for file types in a specific directory, you can also do that by changing the period to the directory name. So instead, I could type in something like, let's see if this works. I think it's like that. Yeah, test. So test forward slash will find test and then test two, which is the second directory that is inside of there. You can also take it a step further by sorting a long list. And to do this, you would type in, I'm going to use that example again, and add a pipe. So I'm piping that command over to sort, and this is going to sort it. So now you'll see this Patreon stuff folder at the very end, while you see my Hack 5 stuff folder way at the top. Cool. I'll delve into a few more things you can do with Find on the next episode. In the meantime, practice these, get handy with them, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel as well, which is youtube.com/hack5, and hit that little like button if you got some good info out of this episode. Until then, I want to hear your feedback. Comment below. Be sure to check out our sister show for more Hack 5 episodes of greatness just like this. I'll be there reminding you to trust your Technolust.